So welcome all of you. I hope I'm audible and visible. Please give me a quick thumbs up if my audio video is clear. And all of you are welcome in the next session of Let's Crack Neet PG Dermatology with me, Dr. Cheshta Agarwal. So brief introduction, I'm Dr. Cheshta Agarwal, your Neet PG educator on an academy. And I have myself scored All India rank 261 in my entrance examination. I will help all of you to get a good rank in your exam as well. Now we have an amazing offer going on right now on an academy, and that is that if you use the referral code Dr. Cheshta YT, you will get, and if you buy a 3-month subscription, you will get a 1-month subscription absolutely free. So I request all of you to please get a 1-month, 3-month subscription of An Academy using my referral code, that is Dr. Cheshta YT. Now another is all those students who are eligible for the next 2020 examination or the exams from 2022 onwards, I will request you to go ahead with Iconic subscription. Now why I want you to go to Iconic, because Iconic give you an access to An Academy as well as Prep Ladder. So you will have the live access to An Academy classes, as well as you can have access to the recorded sessions of Prep Ladder. Along with that, you can also get the subject wise notes, which is very important for all of you. So I request each and every one of you to please go ahead with an Iconic subscription of An Academy. Please use the code Dr. Cheshta YT. Currently we have an amazing offer going on. Now this is a very limited period offer. There are many students who are complaining that, ma'am, the offer is over. So I request all of you to please take or please utilize the offers which are going on. Don't waste your time in thinking. Nextly, we have a lot of questions present on An Academy app. So just download the An Academy learning app and avail or start practicing with the help of all the MCQs. We have many batch courses which are starting from 5th of May. And these are the target next exam, the FMGE batch course, then we have NEET PG session number 1, and then we have INI MCQ marathon batch. All these sessions will be starting from Monday or from 5th. So I request all of you to please be a part of it, okay? Now starting with the today's session. Now from today onward, every day, we will be doing a case series which is called as One Day One Case series. Now here every day I'll discuss one question or one case, and I will also discuss the related questions, the related theory part, which is important for all of you. Now today's topic is the One Day One Case series, a case of genital warts. I request all of you to please be live every day so that you can have an access to all the series or cases which I am going to present every day at 8:30 p.m. Now a very important notice that tomorrow and day after tomorrow we won't be having any 8:30 session because of the plus class. We will be having the session in the morning, that is 12:05 p.m. That is the afternoon. I request all of you to please be live at afternoon 12:30 p.m. for tomorrow and day after tomorrow. Starting with the first question, I request all of you to please answer this question. The female patient with multiple warty lesions around the vulva, the lesions are gradually increasing and on examination they are soft, sessile, did not bleed on touch. What is the diagnosis? So this is a case, today's case. I want all of you to please solve the today's case. So very nice. Welcome Dr. Kostu, Mishba, Vijaya. Everybody is welcome in today's session. Very nice. So a female patient presents with multiple warty lesions around the vulva. The lesions are gradually increasing and on examination they are soft, sessile and did not bleed on touch. Very nice. The correct answer here is condyloma acuminata. And what is condyloma acuminata? It is nothing but another name for genital warts. So today we will discuss in detail what are the genital warts, how they present and how to differentiate the genital warts from the other four options which is given in the question. Now first of all, please remember the genital warts or verruca. They always have rough surface like this. Please remember, the genital warts or verruca have rough surface. When you compare it with that of herpes genitalis, which is round erythematous, multiple round painful ulcer, now this is genital molluscum. How does genital molluscum appears? Genital molluscum will have the presence of pearly shiny papule with central umbilication. Okay, very important. So you have multiple shiny papules with central umbilication. Now this is condyloma lata, which is seen in the patient of secondary syphilis, and this is condyloma acuminata, which is nothing but the genital warts. I request all of you to please compare all four images. This is condyloma acuminata. Now if you look at the lesions of condyloma lata, they are flat topped like this. But if you look at the lesions of condyloma acuminata, they are verrucous. If you want, I can zoom these images. Please look at this. The image is showing you the flat topped lesions, but when you compare it with that of the condyloma acuminata, here you have multiple warty papules with rough surface. So remember, this is very important. Both these images you have to differentiate clinically, even the herpes as well as genital molluscum. So this is the herpes, where you have multiple painful lesions over the genitals, and in the patients of molluscum you will have presence of pearly shiny papules with central umbilication. You can see that there is pearly shiny papules with central umbilication. Clear all of you? Please give me a thumbs up if this question is clear. A female patient with warty lesions around the vulva, it means that you are dealing with a case of condyloma acuminata. Now what is condyloma? It is a human papilloma virus infection. What is human papilloma virus or HPV? It is a DNA virus. Please remember, it is the commonest viral skin disease. Can anybody tell me which is the commonest infection of the children? Which is the commonest skin infection of the children? Anyone, which is the commonest skin infection of children? Anybody can answer this question. Very nice. If they tell you that the commonest skin infection, the answer becomes impetigo. But if they ask you commonest viral skin infection, then the answer becomes the warts. Understood all of you? Very important point. HPV, that is impetigo, which is the commonest skin infection, while the warts is the commonest viral skin infections. Okay, and this is a DNA virus. All of these are exam questions. Now the warts or the HPV infection, the warts or the HPV infection can cause two type of wart, non-genital and genital. The genital wart is called as condyloma acuminata, while the non-genital warts are of four type: common wart, which is also called as verruca vulgaris; plain wart, which is also called as verruca plana; and plantar wart and filiform wart, which is also called as digitate wart. The plantar wort are of two type, mosaic and myrmecia type. Please remember, this is a very very important differentiating point which all of you should know. Now, Mishba impetigo is the bacterial infection. Impetigo is the bacterial infection, and it is considered to be the commonest skin infection in the children. Okay, clear or not all of you? Yes. Starting with our discussion of common wort, which is also called as Verruca vulgaris. Now, how does Verruca vulgaris present? They have a papule with verrucous surface. Can you see? There is a papule which is present over the digit, which consists of rough or verrucous surface. The HPV which causes this is HPV2. Very important question. Please remember, it's a very very important question, that what strain of HPV causes common wort. Next is plain wort, which is also called as Verruca plana. Now, how does it look? Can you see plain flat topped lesions? Very very classical of Verruca plana. And the causative agent is HPV 3 and 10. Now, plain wort, they are flat topped instead of rough surface like this. Very important point, that they have plain topped instead of the rough surface. Very frequently seen in the beard area in male and in the eyebrow areas in female. And what is the commonest reason? The reason is in beard area because of frequent shaving by the parlors or the barbers. So the either the brush or the trimmer, they are contaminated, and that is how they can have spread of the infection. In females, it is mainly because of the threading, in which they use the same thread to remove the hairs of the eyebrows in different individuals. Understood? So very important, that is plain wort or Verruca plana. Now coming to the plantar wort. The causative agent is HPV1. Very important, HPV1. Now for plantar wort, there are two predisposing factors. The very important one is hyperhidrosis, which means that there is increase in sweating. Now, why it is considered to be important? Because whenever you have sweating, what happens? The skin becomes macerated, and whenever you have macerated skin, it becomes soft and there is increased penetration of HPV. Now, there are two types of HPV infection. This type is called as myrmecia, and the lower one is called as the mosaic. So please remember. Okay, how to differentiate between Verruca plana and condyloma lata? Kostubh, please remember, first of all, condyloma lata are present only over the genital part. But Verruca plana, they are never present on the genital areas. Verruca plana will always be present over the other parts of the body other than genital. In genital, the HPV infection will always have the verrucous lesion, which is given a term condyloma acuminata. Understood, Dr. Kostu? Please give me a thumbs up if you understood this point. And for plantar wort, remember, you have HPV1, which is the causative agent. Now coming to the filiform wort or digited wort. Now can you see? They are looking as if the finger-like projections are coming out of the skin. Can you see it here? A very, very clear image which is seen here. Can you see this image? Even in the lower image, you can see the finger-like projections which is coming. So this is called as digited warts. They are usually present singly. Okay? They are usually present singly. Now coming to the another part, that is genital wart, which is also called as condyloma acuminata. In genital wart, the HPV strain is HPV 6 and 11. It is transmitted through the sexual contact. and the frequent site is the coronal sulcus of the penile shaft. Can you see this here? Very classical. You can see that there are multiple verrucous lesions. Can you see? Finger-like projections like this. Multiple verrucous lesions present over the coronal sulcus. Very, very classical of the genital wart. The strain of HPV is HPV 6 and 11. Now, this is in case of females. You can see that the labia majora, even extending up to the labia minora, you have multiple lesions which have combined together to form large areas of verrucous lesions. Very, very classical of genital wart. Now, sometimes what happens, the genital wart becomes very large in size in such a way that it causes destruction of the local morphology of the genitalia. In those cases, it has been given a term that is called as Buschke-Lowenstein tumor. So please look at this image. I'll zoom the image for you. Can you see the lesion becomes very large in such a way that it has distorted the morphology of the external genitalia? Now please remember, the HPV causing Buschke-Lowenstein is HPV 6 and 11. It is a pre-malignant condition, and that is why you have to monitor the patient, and if the patient develops this condition, you have to ask to get it removed, otherwise it can subsequently convert into malignancy. Please remember, it is because of HPV 6 and 11, not because of 16-18. Because I have seen many of you think that it is a malignancy, so it should be 16-18, but that is not true. It is 6 and 11 which occurs because of extension of the condyloma acuminata or the genital warts. Clear? Now, what if you do the biopsy? How many of you were present in my morning session of histopathology? How many of you were live in my morning session? Anybody can tell me the answer? Yes. So, in the morning session, I have told you that in viral infection, you tend to see intracellular edema. You see intracellular edema, which is also called as ballooning degeneration. And why it happens? Because of intracellular accumulation of the fluid. So please look at this image. This is the stratum corneum. Then you have normal stratum granulosum. But the cells of stratum spinosum, it shows intracellular edema. And this intracellular edema will give them a round appearance, which is called as coelocyte. Mishba, there is no Henderson-Peterson body. Where do you see Henderson-Peterson body? Anyone? Yes. Henderson-Peterson bodies, they are feature of molluscum. They are not the features of the HPV infection. In HPV, you have to remember that you have coelocyte. This term is very, very important for you to remember. That is, you have coelocyte. Now coming to the treatment part. There is one dictum you should remember, and that is, there is no oral medication available for the treatment of verruca vulgaris. You don't have any oral medication available. What are the medications which you give? You give topical treatment. The main purpose is you have to do the keratolysis. Why you want to do keratolysis? Because the keratinocytes, which is infected with the virus, you want them to be removed. So you will use trichloroacetic acid or salicylic acid to remove them. You can even use retinoids to remove them. There is a drug which is called as podophyllin. Can anybody tell me what is the mechanism of podophyllin? Anyone? What is the mechanism of podophyllin? Yes, the mechanism of action is podophyllin causes metaphase arrest. So it decreases the cell division. So what is the basic problem in the patients of verruca infection or the viral infection is the viral DNA, it integrates with that of the cellular DNA and it causes rapid proliferation of the cell, and along with the cell it causes rapid proliferation of the virus also. So when we reduce or when we cause metaphase arrest, the cellular division is reduced, and that is how you can reduce the warts or the lesions which are formed. Okay. Now we can also go for surgical therapies, like we can use electrocauteries, radio frequencies, you can even use carbon dioxide ablative lasers, cryotherapy where you give liquid nitrogen of minus 196 degrees centigrade, etc. Now I want all of you to please answer this question. This is a recent AIIMS question. This is the recent AIIMS question, 2019 I guess, 1920 AIIMS question. Please answer this question, all of you. Very nice. Please answer. A female, this is the repeat question, previous year MCQ. A female with active genital warts, history of recurrence, but her husband doesn't have it. What is the advice you will give to prevent the transmission? Anyone? Mishba, then we have Kostup, we have Laifung, then we have Madhu, Vijaya. Who else? We have a lot of students with us. I request all of you to answer this previous year MCQ question from AIIMS. Female presented with active genital lesions, the history of recurrence, but the husband doesn't have it. What is the advice you will give to prevent the transmission? Anyone? Welcome, Dr. Virat. Welcome to the class. Can you answer the question? What about you, Dr. Kostup? Okay. So Madhu, Maria have answered option number 2. Madhu have marked option number 3. Maria have marked option number 2. Pavan and Mishba is option number 4. Laifung is option number 2. Okay. If you remember, few seconds back, I have told you that there is no oral medication available. Did you understand the meaning of this? There is no oral medication available for treatment as well as for prophylaxis. Please remember this. This gola is very important gola. Okay. You have to remember this, that there is no treatment or prophylactic oral medication available. So you cannot give any antivirals to the patient or to the husband, because there is no role of oral medication. The best thing which you can do is ask the patient not to involve in sexual intercourse, because direct contact can give rise to spread of the disease. So this was a repeat question, and still majority of you were not able to answer this question. Please don't make this mistake. Again requesting all my students, please subscribe to Unacademy. You have a golden opportunity, because the exam got postponed. All these previous year MCQs, if you are not able to answer now, it's a very, very bad sign. So please subscribe to Unacademy using the referral code Dr. Cheshta YT and master your previous year MCQ with me, that is Dr. Cheshta. Okay, all of you. So Dr. Virat, Gaurav, Mishba, Pavan, Laifung, everyone have understood this point. Now I want to tell you a little bit about the podovort or the podophyllin, which is a very, very important. So I have just put up this picture. I don't want to tell anything about the brand. So nothing related to the brand. The only thing I've put up this picture is to tell you that this is how you have podophyllin resins available in the market. Now, how do you use podophyllin? First of all, remember that it causes metaphase arrest. It causes metaphase arrest. Now, podophyllin is a plant-derived resin which has to be applied by the health care worker or the doctor in the clinic. Please remember, you never ask the patient to apply the podophyllin by themselves, because it has a very, very strong irritant potential, and that is why we do not want anybody to get their skin burnt. So we have to ask the patient to come frequently to the clinic for application of podowatt. Now please remember, podowatt is a preferred treatment modality for genital warts. Now, can anybody tell me what will be your treatment of choice for genital warts in a pregnant patient? Anyone? What will be the treatment of choice of genital wart in a pregnant patient? Will you give podophyllin or you will give something else? Mishba, Gaurav, Dr. Virat, Laifung, Maria, Madhu, everybody, I request you to answer the question. Again, this was a neat PG question. What should be given to a pregnant female having extensive genital wart? Will you give podophyllin? Very well done, all my dear students. Never give podophyllin to a pregnant patient. And why so? Because it is highly teratogenic. You will not give podophyllin to a pregnant patient. In a pregnant patient, the treatment of choice is trichloroacetic acid and cryotherapy. Both of them is considered to be the treatment of choice for the genital warts in a pregnant patient. ठीक है, clear? Please give me a quick thumbs up. Cryotherapy and tricyclic acid is a treatment of choice in a pregnant female because podophyllin is teratogenic. Now another drug which is used for the treatment of genital wart is imiquimod. So please remember, the another drug is imiquimod. Can anybody tell me what is the mechanism of action of imiquimod? Anyone? What is the mechanism of action of imiquimod for taking care of genital warts? Anybody can tell me the answer. What is the mechanism of action of imiquimod? Mishba, Gaurav, I'm requesting all of you, Mishba, if you like my classes, please subscribe to an academy. These are not enough for your entrance examination. You need to have the access to the plus courses of an academy, which is way too important. These classes are just trailers. You have a whole movie which is there on your plus subscription. So please subscribe to an academy. Very nice. Please remember, it is a immunomodulator. Imiquimod is a immunomodulator. Please remember, it is a immunomodulator which works on toll-like receptor 7. And it causes immune modulation. When you have immune modulation, there is decrease in the proliferation of the cells, as well as there is decrease in the proliferation of the viral particle. And this will give rise to improvement in the lesion. Now, my second question is, can you give imiquimod in a pregnant patient? Yes or no? Can you give imiquimod in pregnant patient? Can you give this in a pregnant patient? Yes or no? Mishba, Amreen, Kostub, Gaurav, Madhu, Pavan, Maria, everybody, Lifeong, I am waiting for your answers. Can you give the imiquimod to a pregnant patient? Like we have discussed that. So Amarjeet, if you are a NEET UG aspirant, welcome to this session. But these classes are mainly dedicated to NEET PG. If you like them, you can subscribe even to the NEET UG by using the referral code Dr. Cheshtav IT. Okay? We have a great educators for NEET UG as well on an academy platform. Yes, so please remember, you will never give imiquimoid in a pregnant patient. Why? Because again, the same explanation, because imiquimoid is a teratogenic drug. You don't have to give them in a pregnant patient also. I hope this is clear to all of you. Please give me a quick thumbs up, everyone, if this is clear. Now I'll show you a few images how the cryotherapy is done. So cryotherapy, we use a cryo gun. So this is a cryo gun. I'll show you the image by zooming it for you. So this is a cryo gun. The cylinder is filled with liquid nitrogen of -196°C. When you press this knob, this is the knob. When you press it, there will be a spray of liquid nitrogen which comes from this end. Okay. So this is like a gun. When you press the trigger, the spray will come out somewhat like this. So can you see the spray of liquid nitrogen is coming? This will cause freezing of the area. Okay. So liquid nitrogen will freeze the area. And when we do repeated freezing and throwing, it causes damage to the skin. It causes damage to the cell, giving rise to improvement. Very, very important. Pavan, it is -196°C. Liquid nitrogen. Okay. Liquid nitrogen of -196°C. So this is how the cryotherapy is done. You can even give trichloroacetic acid. There are various percentage which is available. 10%, you have 20%, 50%, 70%. And you have 90%, which is also called as TCA cross. And this TCA cross is used for taking care of acne scars. So you have variable strength of trichloroacetic acid. Depending upon the involvement, the area of involvement, you use the different strength of trichloroacetic acid. It causes, what does TCA do? It causes controlled destruction. It causes controlled destruction of the skin. Depending upon the strength, more the strength, deeper is the penetration, more is the destruction. So depending upon the strength, you have to use the trichloroacetic acid. Now we do have some vaccines available which is used to prevent the cancer. Please remember, the vaccines are available to prevent the development of cervical cancers. Please remember, it will not prevent the development of genital wart. But they are nowadays claimed that the quadrivalent as well as the nanovalent drugs, which includes HPV 6 and 11, can give you a protective coverage against the genital wart also. But the Cervarix, which is a bivalent vaccine against HPV 6 and 11, will not give you any protection against the genital warts. Please give me a thumbs up. Maria, in acne scars, when you use the 90% or above, that is TCA cross, it causes collagen stimulation. Okay. And whenever you have collagen stimulation, you have filling up of the acne scars. Okay. Now, lastly, I want to discuss a very, very important point or a very, very important disease, that is epidermodysplasia verusiformis, also called as EDV. It is also a viral infection which occurs secondary to human papilloma virus. Please remember, it is very, very important. It works against the HPV. And what are the HPV strains which causes this? It is HPV 5, HPV 8 and HPV 14. Now clinically, please remember, it can have two type of lesions. One is pitriasis versicolor like lesions and another is you have veruca plana like lesions. Please remember, in epidermodysplasia verusiformis, you can have either pityriasis versicolor like hypopigmented lesions, or you can have verruca plana like lesions. Okay, so both these features can be seen, and they have an increased susceptibility to the viral infection. If they are not taken care, they can convert into malignancy later on. So these individuals should be followed regularly, so that if there is any malignant transformation, you can catch it soon and you can treat the patient accordingly. So you are done. We are done with all the questions related to the HPV infection. Please give me a thumbs up if you all have understood the today's class. Please give me a quick thumbs up if all of you understood the today's session. This was a very interesting short session on the genital wart. I request all of you to please subscribe to Unacademy using the referral code DrCheshtaYT and avail the amazing discounts which is available on the platform. So bye bye all of you. Take care. Good night. We'll meet again.